What is up, guys? Thanks for tuning in for episode 90 of the Madden Franchise Playing With Myself series. It is a big day. It is Super Bowl 53, and we're headed to Miami to play the New England Patriots. I did a little bit of checking, and we played the Patriots one time in this career. Only one. And it came in 2017, last season. We played them in the... A little bit of superstition here. We played them in week 17 to wrap up last season before we got into the playoffs. And we won that one 24-14. And in that game, Philip Dorsett had a big, big 75-yard touchdown catch. And that was the final play. It was unnecessary. I was up 17-14 at that point. And I had my playoff berth wrapped up at that point, so figured I'd just have a little bit of fun and put one up stats wise. And we'll see if they use that as a motivating factor.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports.
As we play.
The time for talk is over as we are just mere moments away from the Super Bowl. Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Buccaneers going up against the Patriots.
Marcus Colston, the number one receiver for the Patriots. He's got 77 speed, so I'm really worried about him burning people.
Immortality is in sight. We're nearing kickoff in this Super Bowl matchup between the Patriots.
Here come the Patriots out onto the field. Ah, Jeff Fisher, the new coach. I forgot he was here. Here we come. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Ready to go. Look at that. I'm two games better than 500. Real happy about that. Here's Jeff Fisher. Psyching up AJ McCarron.
Pleased to bring in the third member of our broadcast team, Danielle Bellini, with the report from the sidelines.
Thanks, guys. We've called the Super Bowl together for so many years now, but each year it just gets even more exciting. And this year the spectacle is at an all-time high. Once again, we've got two teams who've been chomping at the bit to finally get out here and chase down that Lombardi Trophy. Back to you.
Thanks, Danielle. Now we'll go to the field. The Patriots are ready to run back this kick.
Sivahina Gregory, ready to return the opening kickoff of Super Bowl 53. It is January 2019, maybe February 2019. And flash your cameras because we are underway. That ball's going to be fielded at the 3-yard line and taken out to the 27. Draven Woodson, Davin Woodson, safety I drafted a few years back. Unless it was a Woodson on their team that you saw, in that case I don't know who it was. Oh no, wasn't the middle linebacker's name Woodson too, that we were talking about? Shaquan or whatever? And Gronkowski gets the first catch of the Super Bowl.
Here's a look at the offense. And if they're going to win today, this group of wide receivers must go vertical.
Yeah, then that was the safety.
That pass play picked up only four. Second down and six coming up.
He might have been here since my first year here. There goes Ben Heaney, breaking into the backfield, getting attacked for loss. And he's a big reason why we're here. That big forced fumble that Honey Badger picked up and took to the house to put that one away against Seattle in the NFC Conference game. Third and seven. Ben Heaney chasing A.J. McCarron and making him launch it out of bounds. And the Patriots go three and out on the first drive of Super Bowl 53.
And so now they'll bring out Allen to punt.
Cordarrelle Pitt. Patterson fields it at the two. Maybe should have let that one go ahead and bounce through the end zone, but we'll take over at the 11.
The former Heisman Trophy winner who led Florida State to a national championship, Jameis Winston.
We've got two quarterbacks who have won national championships looking to win Super Bowls. Should we? Dare I? Oh, what was that? Figured I'd take a big shot on first down and see what happened. And what happened was nothing too amazing. I was distracted by an email I got on my phone. And this is probably the reason why you're not allowed your cell phones on the sidelines. Safarian Jenkins, all broken tackle. Whole lot of yards. Oh, what a play by Safarian Jenkins. 51 yards, and it's only fitting that the man with the two most prolific receiving seasons in football history strikes big in the Super Bowl. It's funny, you know, you take a shot for a big burner play. This is true. Dorsett dropped it. Somehow he almost came up with that. My cup is empty. That's not good news. I gotta wait till halftime to get that refill. What's 36 doing creeping up? He baited me into that perfect. So both teams are unable to score on their first drives of the Super Bowl. The Patriots get the first turnover of the game.
Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive play.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three and out business.
Well, that's a bad business to be in. I know, I get in a lot of bad business.
Let's go!
Second down and nine. We'll go around.
Heaney just barely got the leg there. Stewart falls forward for three. And it's going to be third and seven.
Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stop him for a short game.
Got that zone blitz still in effect here.
They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun.
And there's another three and out. As McCarron throws it over Gronkowski's head. What a punt. Cordarrelle Patterson going all the way back to the 15. A couple spin moves. Gets out there to the 39. 23-24 yard return there by Patterson. Definitely is. The D is looking real nice right now. The offense, not too bad. Just a simple mistake. Oh, that might be a face mask. They're not going to call it. Josh Gordon, three receptions. He'll be lucky if he gets three receptions in the game. He'll be lucky if he gets one in the game. Rawls picking up the first down there. Yeah, that's the problem I make a lot is I pay attention to them goals and ends up costing me. Set. Gets himself his first catch of the game. Buck Allen, this is your time to shine, brother. This is your time to shine. How you doing there, Dampy? Welcome to Super Bowl 53. You're the second person to say something to me about donating, and I don't know where donations are on Twitch. I didn't even know that I had it turned on. Safarian Jenkins bailing me out on a bad throw. That's going to take us to the end of the... Buck Allen down to the six. And now here on second and three, it's time to look for juice check. I take the sack. Because y'all are being a couple big heads.
This will be the eighth play of this drive. The Buccaneers all bunched up here as they get set at the line. And that's a touchdown.
How about that? Josh Gordon gets the touchdown pass. 9 plays, 62 yards, took 3 minutes off the clock. I know, right? What's that, like, he had 30 catches this regular season. He averages less than 2 a game, and he gets a big catch in the fucking Super Bowl. I don't think he had a single catch in the fucking postseason. But he went up and got that one. Oh, yeah. He's smoking a fat blunt at halftime. He's not even going to wait. They can suspend me now. Fat blunt after the game. Oh, man. Oh, I beat up on A.J. McCarron. Poor Miss Alabama Catherine Webb, well, former Miss Alabama Catherine Webb, gonna have to nurse her husband's wounds after that hit. I assume they got married. Maybe they're not married. I don't know. I just wish Brent Musburger was here to talk about how hot she is in the crowd. Yeah, I wonder what they would say, like, if you're gonna do that, like, say the Super Bowl was in Seattle or Denver, where it's legal to smoke weed, and you knew, like, say you were retiring, and, you know, something so you wouldn't have to deal with the penalty. If your team won the Super Bowl, just pull out a blunt and smoke it on the field. As the ticker tape floats down, and your team's getting ready to hoist get the trophy up on the podium. Obviously, like, not on the sideline during the game. That probably wouldn't go over well. Let's go, defense. Make the play. Rip that out. Rip that out. Everybody's hitting him. Beating up on the old man. Marcus Colston. I sold every kind of porn that there was, my friend. Except for bestiality porn and kid porn. Yeah, we sold gay porn. Yeah, Ben Heaney, clipping the foot. Kyle Fuller. Why not bestiality porn? Because it was against the law. Well, it still is against the law. It wasn't. Not just was. It is against the law. You also can't sell... the nostril porn, I believe, would just go on the fetish rack. I don't believe there's anybody that would have a problem with nostril porn. Oh, big hit there. The only stuff that's illegal to sell in America is kiddie porn, animal porn, scat, and piss stuff. So poop and piss, no good. I'm going to assume that you meant the nostril porn there and not the poop and piss. Okay. Snuff films are not allowed. But you can have choking and smothering that doesn't result in death, as weird as that is. Oh, big hit there. The Tina nostrils. It's an up and coming porn, you know, fetish that we'll have to end up with a full shelf for someday. I'm paying too much attention to porn conversation, not enough attention to what's going on the field here. Gordon almost got me picked. Trying to give him another catch here. Josh Gordon, that's what that smell is. Boom! Big hit by D. Woodson. whoever D. Woodson is. You called his name out during Super Bowl intros, Dean. It got him excited. Oh, he gave me the wrong guy, and that's going to let Gronk roll all the way down. Wow. And by jumping on the wrong guy, I dive on the ground, give up a huge pass play to Gronk that sets up a quick touchdown for Olsen, and all of a sudden it's a 7-7 game, assuming I don't block this kick. I blocked it, but it's no good. It was a penalty. They're going to re-kick it. And I might be wrong, but I think that offsides call is the first penalty of the Super Bowl. So if anybody had offsides on an extra point attempt on your pool as the first penalty, you just won $5 or something like that. Hey, look, there's Jeff Fisher. We're back in it, boys. He's real happy about that. He thinks they've got a chance. Oh, great play by the linebacker there. Buck Allen gets it down to 3rd and 2. Juice picks up the first. All different prices, man. We had some stuff that, you know, knew was 4 for $20. We actually had some titles that were a part of a sale that was 4 for $10. The cheapest single titles tended to run around $8 to $10. Used titles you could get as cheap as, you know, $1 to $2 a disc if we didn't have the cases for them anymore.
40% on the day.
Everybody's tired as fuck right now. Let's put Rawls in.
Coming to the line at the 44. First down at the 44. Hand off out of the eye. And that's a game.
Call the timeout here. Just got it off. It is free online, and that's a major part of the reason why we went out of business. You know, we went from being stores that were making seven figures as recently as 2006, 2007, to being stores that were making, get in there, touchdowns at Farian Jenkins, to stores that were making in 2012 when we closed our last store for the year, it made I've got the numbers written down somewhere. I want to say it was like $167,000 for the whole year, which, I mean, it might seem like quite a lot, but then you've got to realize that you're paying your rent, you're paying your all your utilities, you're paying your insurance, you're paying your staff, you're paying for merchandise. So, you know, that was the final year. Like, the last couple years, the profit margin went down, but that was the year that was like, we gotta stop. Hey, it's fitting. It's fitting. Well, I guess it's fitting is a pretty funny statement, too. And that's going to take us to halftime with a 14-7 lead. Oh, okay. Call the play, so I got to call a play to get to halftime. No, I don't want a halftime report. I want a halftime show.
Competitive game, and that's what we have. Both teams have to feel like they're in good shape, and that should lead to a wild finish down the stretch. All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half.
The highlights from the first half? No. We need a halftime show. Buccaneers end up throwing a pick to end the drive. There's that Josh Gordon touchdown.
Bucks land the first punt. We go to the second. The completion will be made on the slant, and he'll eventually be brought down, but not before getting to their own 33-yard line.
Ah, yeah, good call there. Thank you, Dean. I don't care what they say about Jameis Winston or Josh Gordon. You're the real MVP. And fittingly enough, during halftime at the Super Bowl, I'm getting myself a glass of Pepsi. All right. Double penetration?
Both of these teams can envision the championship right now. The Buccaneers take the field here in the second half.
Well, if the ass is dirty, the DP might get shitty. Yep, I have been married It is, what, 2016? In March, the end of March, I will have been married for 13 years. And no, my wife did not shoot nostril porn. Oh, just over Cook's head. They're giving me the goal of 3 receptions by Josh Gordon again. I don't know who he paid off to get looks in the Super Bowl, but they sure are fucking trying. Oh, nice hit. I'm going to let the rookie come in here, get himself a carry. Oh, Brandon Cooks let the corner come. 3rd and 11. How you doing there, man? Does she know I sold porn? I assume she does, since we've been married 13 years, and I sold porn for a decade of it. I mean, she might have questions about where I went all those days and where I was working. Oh. Oh, almost popped up perfect. I wouldn't have been shocked to see this kid make that punt like that. So, a Raiders fan, man, you gotta be real happy with the future of your squad, how it looks laid out before you. My job now, eventually, I'm working on it being my streaming and my podcast. I've been building my website, working to launch my podcast, which I've been dragging my feet on. And then I just started getting into streaming once I got the PlayStation 4. And I realized the market for it. Well, you're coming up. You came up against, you know, an amazing defense in Denver and a solid defense in Kansas City and mediocre Chargers team. So, I mean, it's been a rough division, but it definitely looks like things are set up for it to be a division that you can be, if not the champion of, at least contending for the division title for the next decade or so.
Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team.
Kyle Fuller with a big hit there. Yeah, I agree. If I had to pick right now, I think that it would probably be Oakland winning the West next year. But, I mean, the Chiefs do have some nice pieces. We'll see how free agency deals with them. That's awesome, dude. I see that. 69 views. What's funny, last season I got knocked out of the playoffs by Seattle in the divisional round. That was episode 67. If I had made it to the Super Bowl, it would have actually been episode 69 of the Playing With Myself franchise stream. Yeah, were you trying to add me on here, or are you trying to add me on PlayStation? If you're adding me on Twitch, go ahead and just follow, and I'll follow back. If you're adding me on PlayStation, give me a second to hit a dead spot in the game. Oh, terrible. Yeah, that's the name of this series of videos. I named the franchise Playing With Myself, which is a name I originally came up with either last year's Madden or the Madden before, because you had to name your franchise when you saved it to the cloud. And I just came up with Playing With Myself because I thought it was a funny name. Oh, terrible. Went and got him anyway.
You talk about a blitz on the defensive side. It's all about timing. Disguise it for the last second and time up the snap of the football. They did it.
All right, there's my PSN name. Anybody who's watching this video on YouTube once it's uploaded, that wants to add me can feel free as well. Just send me a message and let me know that you got it from my stream. That way, I'm not like, who the fuck's this guy, and just ignore it. And I'll accept your ad right after this is done. Bigfoot from hell. I just got it there. Third and 19. Kyle Fuller got another one. Back-to-back games, Kyle Fuller has two picks in. Took the big shot to Cooks. Yeah, he definitely wants to get paid, man. He definitely wants me to re-sign him to a big money contract. Hi, Sam. Nice to meet you as well. I'm Jeremy, but pretty much everybody calls me the porn clerk. Except for PSN. Sony won't call me the porn clerk. They wouldn't let me put porn as my name. The Dean of Extreme. Who you can check out on the, what is it, Wrestling with Valiance podcast. Get on Google, go find that if you're a wrestling fan.
When you can't hit the quarterback, the foot pressure on the done then. That time, quarterback had time, throws it down the field for another completion.
Winston's completion percentage, 50% on the day.
Sadly, my American name is the same thing as my name. This clock run down here to one and then hand it to Juice. Try and push it up the middle.
Trying to beat the play clock.
And he gets in. And speaking of picks, on the next episode, you're going to be picking apart that Kimbo Slice fight. Have you been back since, or have you just been here since you came here? It took me a second to realize that meant that you were trying to say cardio there. I was like, what the fuck's a CS radio? Oh shit, man. You need to stop following me on Twitch and adding me on PlayStation and go play some basketball. Oh, I thought Heaney had a pick. And that takes us to the 2-minute warning with a 21-7 lead in Super Bowl 53. We're going to start playing some quarter because they are going to definitely start making some mistakes here. Oh, I didn't get all my changes made. And it put me in. I don't even know what it put me in.
McCarron's got it in the gun. Catch made near the sideline. First down coming up.
If you think you can get a playoff quickly and not use a timeout, you go with a hurry-up offense. That time, a good job by the coach and the quarterback.
Oh, well, that explains why they point out your feet being big. Since you're only 5'11", 5'11 is size 14.5 feet. You know what they say about guys with big feet. Touchdown, Patriots. Making this one exciting. Wait, was that Marcus Colston? Tell me that was 77 speed Marcus Colston. Let me see the back of his uniform. No, it was Gregory. Oh, wow. It was Shavini Vini. And I imagine they're going to go on sides here. No, they're not. They're going to kick away.
Oh,
looking for a repeat of their last drive as they get set for this next.
Oh, it was Rawls already out there? Good to know.
But of course, immediately gave those points right back.
Jim, on the offensive side, everything is clicking. The quarterback's hot. The offensive line's doing an awesome job. Receivers getting open. The running back's running hard. It is one to one.
The Patriots stopped the clock in a hurry, trying to hold on to every precious second.
Two first downs to ice the game, they say. Does he get over the line? I think he does. First down. They're in a zone.
First down at the 35.
No FIFA? I have WWE 2K16, but I'm not a fan of it. I don't have NBA 2K16. I play Madden and FIFA. I play some GTA and I play Battlefield 4. I play some other stuff too, but those are the ones that really get the most of my attention. Thomas Rawls picking up 15 on the ground. And they got a hold on first down, but I still managed to get into position to be able to run for that second first down here. Juice picks up the first down. Hey man, tennis in the face is a really fun game. Wait, did I not throw to Philip Dorsett at all this game? Nice. 5:14 here. I gotta take a shot at Philip Dorsett. Nice meeting you, Sam. I'll accept that invite in a little bit. Call the timeout. Come on, we got to give Dorsett this. Dorsett has been such a big part of our franchise. There's no way we can let him get through the Super Bowl without a touchdown catch.
Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one.
I guess we will let him go through the Super Bowl without a touchdown catch. Oh, better luck next time, Jeff Fisher.
Phil, you experienced it. You won a Super Bowl. I'm looking down at the field, seeing all those players. I can only imagine what it's like.
It doesn't even seem real. That's what it is. You just, when you go to work each training camp, you think, okay, it's all going to fall away.
Apparently I did, man.
You just can't imagine that it all.
Because Josh Gordon got a touchdown. I feel like an asshole throwing a touchdown to Josh Gordon. And I forgot all about that huge catch to Cooks. He had a little problem with that. As of right now, my plans are to remain with Tampa this season coming up. But we'll see. Will never be stronger than this moment. Holy shit, Kyle Fuller is a Super Bowl MVP. Coming out of youth. The emotion of it all, it's almost overwhelming. To realize a dream. He does want to get paid. That moment is realized.
For the rest of your life, you'll be remembered as a Super Bowl champion.
For the rest of my life, I'll be remembered as a Super Bowl champion. Dreams do come true. Milestone completed, 15,000 XP. My contract was extended. 3 years, $5.25 million. So that's that. Take a quick look at that Super Bowl roster. Anthony Costanzo, Shaq Mason, Rodney Hudson, Allie Marpet, Lane Johnson, Austin Seferian-Jenkins, Will Ty, Brian Huerta, Jameis Winston, Mike Glennon, Thomas Rawls, Charles Sims, Buck Allen, rookie, Anthony Bass, however you want to pronounce it, Brandon Cooks, Josh Gordon, Philip Dorsett, Albert Wilson, Travis Benjamin, and Cordarrelle Patterson. On defense, it was Brockers, McCoy, Jernigan, with Tuitt, Spence, and Hartman coming in. Corners were Fuller and Amukamara with Levingston, Philip Gaines, and the rookie whose name I can't fucking remember. Honey Badger, Woodson, Cole, Duke Williams, Malcolm Myers at safety. And then the linebackers are Levante David, Quan Alexander, Ben Heaney, Reggie Blake, Jeffrey, Riley Parker, Galvin, and Kyle Van Noy. And Cody Parkey, who didn't miss a field goal until he missed two in the NFC title game. Not bad. Not bad at all. I bumped up to the number 10 on the coaching legacy. And I want to take a look at season receiving yards. Seferian-Jenkins didn't catch last or 2016's total, so this was the second most yards receiving in a career or a season. And of course last year was fifth. 2016 was first. No record setters anywhere else as far as single season records go. Although, let me check passing yards. Nope, no one since the game took place. So that's that. The Buccaneers are the 2018 champions of the world, Super Bowl 53. If you're watching this on Twitch, thanks for checking it out. Make sure you subscribe so you can see future episodes when we stream live. If you're watching on YouTube, yeah, throw a like to them Super Bowl champion Buccaneers and Kyle Fuller's Super Bowl MVP performance. And make sure you subscribe if you want to catch future videos. This has been episode 90. Episode 91 will be 2019 offseason, and we'll probably get to that later this week. Thank you guys for checking us out. Shout out to Dampy. Shout out to Dean. Sam already left. Shout out to the rest of the quiet guys in here who are watching but not talking. You guys have a good night.